السلام عليكم قرآن ويكلي بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. A second reflection I wanted to share with you guys about Ramadan, continuing with our conversation about the word لعله, is in the ayah شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal in this ayah ends the long injunction with لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Hopefully, perhaps, and so that you will be grateful, that all of you will become grateful. So whatever Allah has said in this surah, or in this ayah particularly, the point of it is to make you and me grateful. Last time I talked to you about the point of fasting being that we develop taqwa, and how that's kind of related, what the logical connection there is. But here I want to highlight, what is it that Allah wants us to be grateful for in Ramadan? The surah begins, you know, and the way it begins to me is remarkable. When we think of Ramadan, at least me, the way I was raised and the way our society and community is, when you think of Ramadan, first thing that goes in your mind is fasting, iftar, parties, taraweeh. You know, there's a sequence of events, and probably the biggest thing is fasting. Before anything else, you think of fasting. Allah rearranges our thinking about Ramadan when He introduces us to Ramadan in this ayah. This is the ayah of Ramadan in the Quran. There's no other ayah of Ramadan in the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the one in which the Quran was sent down. And this is actually, rhetorically, it's a really beautiful expression. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not say شهر رمضان الذي أنزلنا فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the one in which we sent the Qur'an down. He didn't mention himself. He says, أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنُ. The Qur'an was sent down in it. The difference between saying we sent it down and it was sent down is huge rhetorically in Arabic. We don't really notice the difference in English. The idea is Allah is highlighting the Qur'an so much so that He doesn't even mention Himself. He highlights the Qur'an to that extent in this ayah to show us the role and the importance of the Qur'an. If Allah had said, أَنزَلْنَا فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ, like أَنزَلْنَا الْمَاءِ, we send down water from the sky. Allah highlights Himself. And what does He send down? Water. Of course, Allah is the one who sends the Qur'an down, but He highlights its importance by making the verb passive and just alluding to the Qur'an directly, saying, this is the month in which the Qur'an came down. So the first thing you should be thinking about in Ramadan is the Qur'an. That's how you should be thinking, month of Qur'an. It's the month in which the celebration of the whole month, the entire ceremony of fasting and celebrating Eid at the end, all of it has to do with the Qur'an. So going into Ramadan, you and I should be thinking, how am I going to come out of Ramadan truly having gotten closer to the Qur'an? Because the entire spirit of Ramadan, according to the ayah, is the Qur'an itself. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. Two things happened here that I've talked about in other lectures, that, you know, from a historical point of view, you know, Jews used to have their own days of fasting, and they had their own revelation. And Allah Azza wa Jal made us a distinct nation. And part of our distinction is that we have our own revelation. And another part of our distinction is that we have our own month of fasting. Another part of our distinction is that we have our own direction of prayer. We used to pray in the same direction as the Jewish community before, until the revelation came. This surah makes us distinct in every way. Like, a few ayat before this ayah, in the same surah, we were just reading about the changing of the Qibla, why we've been made a distinct nation. Now we're reading what else makes you a distinct nation, the revelation, and the month you should celebrate that revelation in, that too. Subhanallah. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن is the celebration of Muslim identity. The fact that we're a new nation. The fact that we are now the nation that Allah chose to give guidance to. It's, you know how nations have like the 4th of July, their independence, or people celebrate, you know, the day in which their nation was formed, or their constitution was passed, etc., etc. For us, our day of our month of constitutional celebration, when we were inaugurated as a nation, that is our month, the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. Then he says something beautiful. He says, "Hudal linnas," it's guidance for all people. You know, the previous nation believed that guidance is just for them. Everybody else is less than them. They don't deserve the guidance. And Allah said, "No, not this time." It is revealed to these people that are going to observe the month of Ramadan and celebrate this book, but it's been sent as a guidance for people. In other words, you get so close to the Quran in this month and really make it like it's running through your bloodstream, like that. And then now you're going to share it with the rest of humanity. هُدَى لِلنَّاسِ. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And it's got clear proofs and evidences from guidance and which distinguishes between right and wrong. So we're going to be the people. Once we become people of Qur'an in Ramadan, we're going to carry its mission out. We're going to be rejuvenated with its message. And we're going to take it out to everybody else and show them the clear proofs of the guidance and the criteria, the distinction between right and wrong inspired by this book. That's what the purpose of Ramadan is, to get the ummah back on its track, you know. Now compare that huge, enormous, amazing message to like what we've reduced Ramadan to. Fried food and like taraweeh while we're yawning. Some arguing about 8 versus 20. Which masjid are we going to go to? I think those guys recite faster, we should go there. Or we should just go, maybe we'll take it seriously on, you know, 27th night or something. We've made it this into a cultural festivities type of thing. And that's all fine, but it's built upon a really grand spirit. It's got this huge identity. You know, we talk about Muslims having an identity crisis. Ramadan is the month where we resolve our identity crisis. That's what it's supposed to be. الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. Allah then gives us certain instructions. Whoever fasts this month and he should, you know, or whoever among you fasts or witnesses this month, he should fast the entire month. How the sick can make it up in future days, etc., etc. But the whole ayah, remember how it ended? So that you can be grateful. The question then is, what should you be grateful for? The first thing you should be grateful for is Ramadan itself. You're grateful that you actually completely وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So that you must, in order that you complete the count, you declare Allah's greatness the way He guided you, and so you can be grateful that you got to complete the 30 days of fasting. You should also be grateful, hopefully you'll become grateful for the Qur'an itself. Hopefully you'll be grateful for being made a new nation, a distinct and honored nation that received this revelation. Hopefully you'll be grateful that Allah gave you an opportunity to cleanse all of your sins and start fresh with this month. There are so many reasons to appreciate Islam and the Qur'an and this message and Allah all anew in Ramadan. The point of Ramadan, so that you can be, hopefully you will become grateful. The point of fasting, you should get taqwa. The point of Ramadan is more grand. You should become grateful. You should appreciate what Allah Azza wa Jalla has given you. So I pray sincerely that this is the month in which we truly show Allah that we're grateful for having the Qur'an. That we read more Qur'an than we've ever read before. We try to understand it more than we've ever tried to understand it before. We memorize more of it than we've ever memorized before. We really become people of Qur'an this coming month of Ramadan, and that perpetuates us, inshallah ta'ala, throughout the rest of the year. Barakallahu li wa lakum, wassalamu alaykum, Qur'an Weekly. Assalamu alaykum, Qur'an Weekly. The Prophet ﷺ told us, الدَّالُّ عَلَى الْخَيْرِ كَفَاعِلِهِ. The one who points to something good gets the same reward as the one who did the good itself. Do me a favor and do all of yourselves a favor and share in the goodness if you benefited from these talks and these videos. Make it a point to share them with friends and family and get the word out. This is such an awesome project. I really, really appreciate the effort Quran Weekly folks have made. And I pray that Allah blesses them even more and brings even more and more good from them. These kinds of efforts, you know, Allah tells us whoever doesn't thank the people hasn't thanked Allah. The hadith of the Prophet ﷺ teaches us that. So we should do that. We should appreciate the effort that's being made here. And the best way to appreciate their effort is to help them get more reward and get yourself more reward at the same time by spreading the word, inshallah ta'ala. Thank you again. Wassalamu alaikum.